Reiki, in a nutshell, what we just discussed was helps heal. Now, heal is not an FDA cleared word for Reiki, because Reiki is not a medical practice, but colloquially we use the word heal, heals the disease at the root cause. Okay. And then automatically things start coming into balance. Now, if you want to go further, you'll say, okay, now I'm in balance, but what is the purpose of my life? What is the higher purpose of my life? I'm reasonably doing well in my social life, my relationships. What more should I do? It's become kind of routine. And that's when you start thinking about, well, what's the higher purpose of life? What is my self-actualization? And that's when a journey in your spine starts. And you become aware of the chakras. Chakras are nothing but states of evolution of your mind. So in the yogic system, there are 6 + 1 = 7 chakras. There are many other chakras also, but these are the major ones. At the base of the spine, you have the root chakra or Mool Adhar. Okay? Mool Adhar means, Mool means base, Adhar means foundation. That's at the base of the spine. It is your basic foundational chakra. It gives you the will to live. If that chakra is malfunctioning, you will not have a will to live. You will have a depression. I want to kill myself. Just a very basic will to live. I don't want to die. Maybe I don't have enough food. I don't have a CEO's job, but I am what I am. I don't want to die. If that chakra is functioning properly, then your consciousness rises up and you start asking yourself, well, what am I going to do with my life? What is my immediate purpose? What should I achieve in this week, next week? That's when the consciousness rises to the abdomen chakra, called Swadhisthan chakra in Sanskrit. Swa means self, Adhisthan means organizing principle. That what is my organizing principle? What is my life organized about, around? What is my personal mission? And that's when your purpose develops. If the Swadhisthan is not functioning, then you will not have a purpose in life. You will see a lot of people when we used to go to these spiritual expos, and I would talk to people and say, what are you doing? Oh, dude, I'm just searching for myself, you know. I've not found myself, right? In India also, when I go to Rishikesh, I find a lot of vagabonds traveling. And they've been searching, and they think that they've realized and they have become mystics, but even their abdomen chakra has not opened up. That clarity of what I'm going to do, if that chakra is functioning, then you'll have a very clear immediate purpose of life. But let's say if you have an immediate purpose of life, whatever scale of purpose it is, you need energy to manifest that purpose of life. You need friends, you need networking, you need education. Sometimes your purpose may need investment, so you may need wealth. That's when the consciousness of the solar chakra above the navel comes into play. Okay? It's called the Manipur chakra. Money means jewels, pur means a place, a placeholder. You know? So wherever the monies, the jewels are kept. If the solar chakra is blocked, then you will have a purpose, but you will not find a way to manifest that purpose. Okay? You will not, oh, I want to work in this company, but I don't know anybody there. Oh, I want to start a business, but I don't have enough investment, enough knowledge. I'm trying to build a network, I'm failing. Then to manifest that immediate purpose, you have to build your solar chakra, the energy being projected from the solar chakra. The negative part about the solar chakra is it's fire. Its nature is of that of fire. It's called solar chakra. Whatever you put in it, it'll burn it and it'll ask for more. So when you have one immediate purpose, you fulfill it, says, oh, now I want to do this, now I want to do that. Keeps burning. You're 40 years, 50 years, 60 years of age. You have a collection of so many skills, but self-realization still not come.